Hello everyone and welcome to this tipple thought for the day. So if anyone's been following a post I made in my forum, you'll know that it's been quite a crazy week for me. I was dearly hoping to get a tutorial out, but the project to install solar power on the house has been going on for the last week. It's quite challenging because putting solar power on a house that is connected to the grid where you can't feed back to the grid for one, legal reasons, and two, technical reasons, poses quite a challenge. But what I'll do, I'm going to walk you through what has been installed, just quickly give an overview of the equipment that's there and where we are at the moment. Then also the other interesting thing I'm going to start off again is the solar powered Kindle case or solar powered Kindle. This is a project that I'm sure some of you will recall. I started off some time ago and then I put it aside because I got busy and I was finding a few challenges with the components that I was using. And as I mentioned in another T4D, a lass, a 16-year-old girl from the States in Washington, D.C. called Karen, emailed me a very nice letter. I must say, it's a pleasure to actually receive a properly written letter these days from anyone, never mind someone who's in high school. She's part of an organization. She and her sister herself have started off an organization where they're hoping to provide what they call a Megabook for underprivileged kids in Africa. They found that basically kids in Africa can read, it's just that they don't have content. So that's where a Megabook or an e-reader potentially is a great solution to the problem, because obviously you can, there's no end of material. The challenge of course is power. So that's where she found me. She saw my solar powered Kindle project and contacted me and asked whether I'd want to partner up and assist her in developing a solution. So, and she actually called me from the States and we had a chat. And I've said, yes, I will kind of expedite my work on it. I don't know that I will arrive at a solution. But David from X-Solar, who's the gent obviously owns X-Solar and is installing, doing the solar power installation, he said he will back my efforts. So thanks to David. And I will work, show you what I have started working on in the hopes that I can produce something. Since I started my project, there is a production solar powered case which is specifically made for the Amazon Kindle 4. So it's very specific and it's quite expensive. It's $80, $80 to $90. So that's the challenge for me, is to produce a proper working solution which is relatively cheap. And I'm hoping that I might have the components to do that. The one interesting thing when we go and take a have a look at it, someone brought to my attention, and again thanks very much to my viewers, it's not the first time it's been brought to my attention, but I did a bit more research. It's a monolithic, small monolithic package which is a MPPT charge controller, but it's a small package for small solar power projects. It's the LT3652 if I remember correctly. I'll put the details below. I am going to try and get some free samples of that for this project and similar projects, so we'll try that. That might be an expensive component, but I'm keen to see how well it works, but I'll show you potentially what might be a cheap setup. And then we'll take a wander through and have a look at the other bits and pieces in the house. But certainly I'll put Karen's details below on the website, so if you're keen to follow that, you can do. I know she is looking for sponsors. In summer next year, US summer, so June, July, she's hoping to get 10 prototypes into Africa to see how well it works. So she's obviously looking for sponsorship for that. So if you do happen to be the kind of person that has that kind of finance and wants to help a project like that, then certainly look below and contact Karen. But let's go and have a look at what I've got set up at the moment. Right, so here I've got set up, and I haven't done much testing at all, and this will be a start of a new series on the solar powered Amazon Kindle. But what I've got, I've moved to those crystalline solar panels which I bought, because the one which I had attached, which I showed you at the back of that solar powered Kindle, doesn't really produce enough current. So I'm experimenting with these three panels. They can open circuit produce 20 volts, closed circuit we'll see, but I've got them linked in parallel.
I'm experimenting with using the hybrid capacitors as a storage because they all store far more than the supercapacitors I was using previously. As you can see today, it is an overcast. It's actually been drizzling and raining. The overcastness, believe it or not, can disperse more light, so that can help. But we're inside behind a window. The sun is on the opposite side of the house. And yet we are still producing power. 9 milliamp, it's been up to 11, 12 milliamp. And as you can see on the brim, and I'll just put the light on, it is actually, driving up the voltage on it. Okay, so it's just gone past 11. I expect this to go to around, I suppose, 16, 17 volts. But the panels, again, aren't orientated correctly. So I'm fairly confident that this might work. I wanted this so that it could be placed inside and just passively collect power, and it looks like in this setup that might work. I am, for the time being, as the other DC to DC converter that I used chewed too much current and was expensive, I have gone to now experimenting with just a cheap car USB charger, if you will. And as I posted a video on this, these are apparently DC to DC converters, and I will attach another multimeter to check the current going in and coming out. This might be a very cheap, eloquent solution, because all you'd need is a switch. So you plug the Amazon Kindle in, let it store up all the power in the hybrid capacitors, flick a switch, and then it charges. But we'll see. There's still a bit of playing around here, and this will form part of a new series on the solar powered Kindle. Okay, so here in my garage is where we've set things up. This is a temporary solution for the lead crystal batteries at the moment. So we've got 850 amp hour batteries. So that's a string in series, another one in series, obviously linked in parallel. So that's a total of 300 amp hour in the batteries themselves. We've then got the output from the solar panels on the roof coming out here. There's a DB board for that, a little mini DB board, and a battery breaker box with some big fuses in it. Then the solar panels feed into this Victron Energy Blue Solar grid tie inverter. That directly converts the power from obviously a high voltage DC in excess of 300 volts DC into AC, 220 volt AC current. That then gets fed onto the mini grid and into the Victron Energy Quattro inverter. Can use that then to charge the battery bank and also obviously pull power out of the battery bank, because this then feeds the house AC. This is all being wired up. The fun and games is, as I said, the one is our house has got some nuisance earth leakage trips, so that's something I'm looking into at the moment. Certainly another education for me, and something once I've learned a bit more about, I'll cover. But once that's resolved, probably tomorrow, which is Monday or Tuesday, this will all be linked up and we should be live. I'll quickly take you outside, even though it's drizzling, just to have a quick poke at the array, or I'll insert a little clip that I took earlier. Then also what we're going to do is there's a battery monitor which will be near our DB board. There's also then data feeds which will come out of these, which will link into my PC, so I can monitor the yield from the roof, what's happening on the Quattro inverter, because that is very configurable. You can tell it to do a lot of things. The beauty about this for South Africa, you can tell it not to feed back onto the grid, or whether to pull in the grid when you see reach a certain consumption level, or to charge a battery. So that will be covered off as well in a later series, what you can do with this Quattro inverter. It's quite a fancy piece of kit. Let me see if I can just show you the array. So there on top of the roof are the one set of three 250 panels. It's one string. And beyond that, there's another string. I'll quickly pop around the other side of the house.
Okay, so let's take you for a shot up of the array.
So as you can see, there's a further six panels there for a total of nine, which means obviously a total of 2,225 watts. The other bit I will be following up on is the electronic DC load. Some comment has been made that the power resistor, which I call a dummy load, is more there as a a reference to the op amp, and they want to see, they say that's what helps with the regulation. As I said, I've actually seen this regulator work fine without it, but I'm going to connect this all up again and demonstrate the kind of regulation with and without this load resistor as well. So I'll be posting that video soon too. Then just to switch over to my lead crystal battery testing, again, this is the one that was supplied by Exolar. I had it on for about 2 days on what I'd call a recovery charge cycle to see if I could get it back, give it half a chance to come back a little bit. I mean, it was still performing fine, but I wanted to see if it would recover if you didn't kind of take it right down to zero. So I only took like an hour of charge out of it and then charged it back up, an hour charge and then charged it back up. And now again, I'm punishing it, taking it down to zero and see how it behaves before I start the final real abusive session of discharging it, leaving it discharged for a day or so and then recharging it. But still, it's holding strong at the moment. As you can see, the light is on, so it's busy on its discharge cycle at the moment.
Right, so as you can see, there's a lot happening. And as I say, this week, besides the disruption, obviously, because we've had our power switched off a lot of the time while the solar installation has been going ahead and trying to troubleshoot the earth leakage issues, I also had a hard drive fail on my PC. So a fair few fun and games this last week. But I think by the middle of next week, things will calm down and I can post a proper video on the solar power installation. And then we'll pick up with the projects and the tutorials again. So anyway, thanks very much for watching, and I certainly do appreciate your support. Cheers.